Howdy! How's everybody out there in YouTube land today? I'm bringing you a little video here to show you what I have been learning about this homemade glue sawdust formula called SADUSDO that my friend Shelly Cole over at Know What Mom Knows came up with. She's got a challenge running right now on making items out of this sawdust clay that she has developed. And I've made a couple things here, and I'm learning a little bit about this. Now, she doesn't charge anything for this. She gives recipe away for free, and you can get sawdust from anybody that's got a saw and create sawdust when they can cut up some wood. So, it's pretty easy to come by, and it can be an all-natural product. You don't put a bunch of additives and stuff in it. This that I've got, for the most part, is pretty natural. Now, I had to kind of embark on some of it a little bit as I learned a few things about the product. It is a learning process for anybody that gets into this on how to work with it, because it's not a manufactured product that you go to the store and buy. This is kind of trial and error, learning how to use this stuff. Shelly's got a lot of tips and tricks and things about the product, because since it's hers, it's something that she's messed with for quite a while. But for the rest of us, you know, we're just starting to learn with this product on how to use it. Now, if you watched my videos the other day, I put out two. I put out one about making the belt buckles, and I put out another one about making some embellishments. And with the belt buckles, I started out, I made this one, and this is one that I put the background of the SADUSDO product in the belt buckle blank. These are just metal belt buckle blanks. And then I decorated the top of it with different colors of the SADUSDO to put little violets in there, purple violets, little yellow centers, and some little green leaves around the edges of them. And I let that firm up, and now that came out really nice. I was really happy with the way that it came out. After it dried, now you can use a natural product on it. It is a shellac that they use to put on food grade products like jelly beans and things. You can get some of that put on there if you want to keep it all natural. I wasn't going to go to the extra expense to do that, so I put Krylon on top of it to seal it. And it, since it is a wood-based product made of sawdust, if it gets wet, see, it would soak up water and that would ruin the product. So I put Krylon on it. It's triple thick Krylon. You can get it in any place they sell paint. I get mine up at Walmart, and you just spray it on there, and that seals it up. So if it ever got wet for any reason, that would not ruin the buckle. So there you have that one. Now, the next one that I did one that was kind of a camouflage color background. And let's see if we can get the light around here a little bit more so you can see it. I've got new lighting here in the studio, and I'm trying to get it all acclimated so everything can be seen real well. But there you go. It's a camouflage type background where I use some yellow and some black and some green and purple in there to make a little camouflage. Then I made these embellishments. And this is a little lizard that I've put in the mold. And there were silicone molds. I'll add that. All the molds that I used the other day were silicone. So this pops out real easy. Now, if you're using a different type of a mold that is rigid, you would need to put it in the freezer for a little bit and let it get good and cold. And then it will pop right out of the mold. But since these are silicone, as soon as they dry, they pop right out. And I glued the lizard down to the background, and I put some Krylon on that. But with this one, it cracked across the deck, right in there, right underneath the lizard there where he is. And when I picked it up, both of the pieces fell out of the buckle itself. So it needed to be re-glued into the buckle, and then the crack in it needed to be re-glued. So I filled all that in with more glue. I glued my lizard on there, and then I went over it with Krylon as soon as the glue was all good and dry. So that's how we did that one. But I'm learning about the cracking in this SADUSDO. It tends to shrink. You see here on the edge where it shrunk. I had this all filled in really, really full of SADUSDO, and it does shrink in whatever kind of a mold or frame you put it into. So you do need to keep that in mind when you're making this. Now with this one, I did like a purple and black, a little bit of green and yellow, and it didn't come out as camouflagey as what the other one did. A lot more purple in this one. But with this one, it cracked off the bejeebers. I mean, there's just cracks all over in that. And it just wasn't going to look pretty unless it was covered up with something. Well, I had made these oak leaves embellishments in a silicone mold. And so that's what I put on this one. This one, I was aiming just to leave it as it was because it was really pretty with purple in it. But when it dried, oh, heavens no. Now, it didn't come out of the buckle. It stayed in the front, but it was just cracked all to heaven's sake, just cracked up. And, you know, I mean, you'll even see in here around the edges of it a little bit, you know, the cracking and the pitting and stuff in it. So what I did is I filled that in with glue, and then I glued on the oak leaves. Now, with the leaves and with the oak leaves, when I glued them on, I taped them down with frog tape, the green painter's tape, to keep them held down while the glue dried. And then after the glue was getting dry, then I went over it with Krylon. Now, I also did this rectangular piece in a silicone mold that had a hole. See if I can tip that so you can see it. Has a hole where you put the jump ring through. And when you go to take these kind of pieces out of the mold, since they have a little rubber gizmo there that you form the SADUSDO or, you know, whatever your medium is around, you pop that piece out first to make sure you get it out of there and don't crack whatever it is that you're using for filler. And then you ease the rest of it out of the mold and it come out, so it come out real nice, except it cracked in the middle. So I glued that all up and I put a dragonfly embellishment across here. Now my dragonfly also cracked. You can probably see right there at the tail portion. And I'll get it up here to the camera a little bit better. You see right there at the tail portion. And so I just glued it together. And I sprayed this with Krylon as soon as all the glue was dry on it. And it's still a really pretty piece. It's just that this SADUSDO medium has a tendency to crack. It dries out and it has a tendency to separate itself and it cracks. So I don't know how exactly to get by with all that. I'm not real sure adding more glue to the mixture is the answer, because the glue is just going to dry out more too with it. So I'm not sure. I'll have to experiment a little bit more with this product and see what I come up with. Now, here's the rest of the embellishments that I made. I made these and they come out really pretty, except they cracked. And this was after they came out of the mold. They came out of the mold, all one piece was fine. It was laying, and the next time I went to pick them up, they would break. So I glued them back together. Both of them cracked. You can see where this one cracked in the middle. And so I don't know. I mean, I really packed it in those molds good and tight when I put it in there, because I said any place that where it's thinner in the mold will have a tendency to break on this. And so I really wanted it packed in there. And still, they broke. So I don't know. Now, the little fine pieces that I did, remember these little lacy owls that I had the mold for? They come out looking pretty nice. I was pretty pleased with those. And that was just a really thin mold that those was in. So those didn't do too bad. My little bitty owls. And these little pieces here, these little gemstone pieces, came out excellent. I was really pleased with those. And they were even a little thicker piece, but they were small. So it seems like the small little tiny pieces did real well, or the really thin pieces did okay. Anything thicker seemed to have a little issue. Now these little embellishments, these fleur-de-lis, you see this had an end on it, and that broke off and flipped out someplace altogether. So, you know, any little fine piece attached to the thicker pieces just didn't fare well. This is another one. I tried gluing this little piece back on here, but there wasn't enough of it, kind of glued up crooked. And there's a little tail that goes on it, a little round piece that goes on the bottom of it, which, you know, isn't really worth trying to save or do anything with. If the rest of it come out one piece, that might be worthwhile to mess with. Now, here's another piece that I did. It's a little pendant piece. And it's got a little hairline crack in it. And didn't break in two. It's got a little hairline crack in it. It would be, you know, if you want to make a piece of jewelry out of this, it would be worth going over it with a little more glue to seal it up really good. Make sure the cracks are all sealed in it so that it doesn't break for whoever's wearing it. Because, I mean, wouldn't that be awful? You're wearing a piece of jewelry, you know, you're bragging to people about this piece of sawdust. Isn't this great? You know, somebody grabs onto it, looks at it, breaks it in two. Holy smoke. Then, here's the buffalo that I did. Now, here again, there's some cracking. There's cracking around his leg down here. There's some cracking right here across the center of the back. And this would be another one that I would want to go over real good with some glue and really push it together good and let it hold before I try to put it on anything. Or you'll end up with an issue out of that. But there's my camouflage colored buffalo that I did. So those are some things that I'm learning about the SADUSDO. I'm not sure exactly what the ratio is that needs to be filled with. We're using one part glue to two parts sawdust for making this product up, and then you just add however much of the colorant that you need to get whatever color it is that you're seeking. And I'm thinking that you need to kind of measure out how much of the colorant that you're using at a time, figure out how much you use total in the batch that you're putting it in, and then add about half that much of the glue mixture to that ball. So let's say, for instance, that you have a ball of sawdust that you're messing with. It might not be the entire batch. You know, let's just say maybe a quarter of the batch, whatever. You pulled it out, you worked it up, you've got it nice and creamy. You go to add your colorant to it. And let's just use an example that you're putting half of a teaspoon of colorant into that ball to get it the color you want. You're working that in and it's looking like it's the right color. You might want to get at least a quarter of a teaspoon more glue and add to that ball. If you need a little bit more but it's still coming out kind of crumbly, add a little bit more until that ball is good and smooth. One of the things that I noticed with the balls of color that I was using in this project is that they were coming out a little bit too crumbly for me, which would indicate why I was getting so much drying. So that's what I'm learning. If your balls of SADUSDO, when you're working it up and kneading it up, seem a little bit crumbly, you're probably going to want to add a little bit more glue to it. And that might keep it from shrinking as much and keep it from cracking. So that's what I'm learning. I'll have a couple more SADUSDO videos coming up in the coming week here, weather permitting and everything rolling along smoothly. So stay tuned. There's more to come. Be sure to check out all my videos, be sure to check out all my videos on SADUSDO that I've done so far, and be sure and check out the URLs that I have in the description of the video. It will tell you there about my Twitch channel, but I do videos on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 3 p.m. Eastern time. I do a live stream on YouTube at 8 p.m. Eastern, where I just talk to the audience, and we all get acquainted and make friends and have some fun. And I put out a few videos every week on YouTube for you to be crafty and creative with. I also have an Etsy channel where I have my artwork, and you can check out all the lovely things that I have on there. Check out my Patreon page where I have some videos up showing you how to do some bigger projects. And I'm on Twitter and I'm on Instagram. So I'm not hard to find. It's BrendaG's every place you look. BrendaG's Designs. With all that being said, there's only one thing left to say, and that's Brenda's Crafty. You like Brenda.